Mrs. Boxler, thanks for joining me today. Tell me, why do you want to run for a school board seat again?
This was a really challenging decision for me this time. I kept going back and forth. Do I want to? Do I not want to? And the bottom line is, it takes up a significant amount of time. When we get that packet, I spend quite a few hours reading it, asking questions to the correct people. So it is a lot of time committed to the community. When I realized that I did not have to run for my at-large seat and I could run for the district, and because of redistricting, it was only going to be 2 years, I decided that I would give it one more shot, give it a try to run for this two-year term, because I think it's what's right for the community. As an educator, I think I can bring something valuable to the school board.
What's the greatest challenge facing the district right now?
We've just overcome so many obstacles and hurdles. I think financially, we're always going to be concerned, although we're in much better shape than we have ever been in many, many, many years, which is exciting. Our administrators are leading us down an excellent path financially, with the allowable growth coming in this year. And we didn't have that the past 2 years. Thankfully, that came through with our legislatures this year, and that's definitely helped us. But I think we're a school system. We're not out to make millions of dollars. We're not a business. We're always going to be faced with, we have to make sure we're spending our money effectively. And I think we are. So it's a challenge, but at the same time, I think we're doing it very well.
And as a school board member for the past 4 years, you've come to understand how the district operates. Mm-hmm. And knowing that, tell me a little bit about what you believe your role is as a member of the school board.
As a member of the school board, I see my role. And keep in mind, we go through, when you become a new school board member, and then as you continue on as a school board member, you go through training through the IASB, Iowa Association for School Board. And it's very important to go through that training, because one of the things you have to keep in mind is, as a school board member, we're not up there to micromanage the district. That's not our position. Our job is to oversee. Our job is to support. Our job is to provide valuable information that we can do. The biggest thing that I see as our job as a school board member is to always be looking at what's best for the children of the Oskaloosa community. We have to always put our children first. That's my opinion.
Next year, the legislator is giving districts 4% allowable growth, and
that's
and that's the amount of additional funding schools receive each year. So with that extra money coming in, what do you believe should be a priority when it comes to allocating those new funds?
I'm going to go ahead and go right back to our administrators one more time on that. I support their decisions. We have asked them questions during meetings. We've asked them questions during individual conferences with them. They're doing a fantastic job of making sure that we're providing and using that money as effectively as possible to, once again, provide the best education for our children. We have to put our academics first. There's no question. So whatever that means, we've got to put our academics first so that our children will be able to learn and have that opportunity to learn.
When people go to the ballot box, they're going to see your name and Neil Haddon's name running against each other, and they're going to choose one of those names. Why should people vote for you?
Well, I hope I bring that experience to the board to begin with. I've already served for 4 years, so I would hope that that would help. I hope that I've lived in several different locations. I hope that that would bring some diversity and some things that I've seen in other districts that I do try and share with our board here. So I would hope that that would help. I'm committed to the school. I'm in the schools all the time because of my job at William Penn. And so I see what's going on. I support them 100%. And I would hope that they would see that as a good thing.